from Television Centre, where I've been seeing some of the programme that are being prepared for your enjoyment this coming autumn. I hope in a few moments to be able to have a few words with someone who's probably television's top drama director.
Right, ready, ready, action!
And I don't never not wish to not see you never more again either, so there.
Thank you, Dame Edith. That was delightful. You and Sir Michael go and have a coffee, and I'll deal with Sir Rachel.
Mr. Scuttle.
Oh, I'm... Was we on the... Hello, viewers. I had no idea we was on, sir.
Well, here he is, a very controversial figure, BBC's top television director, Mr. Fred Scuttle.
Mr. Jean-Paul Scuttle, if you don't mind.
Jean-Paul Scuttle?
Yes, sir. I was named after the existing sensualist, Jean-Paul Sartre.
I see. Well, of course, your productions cover a very large field, don't they?
And of course, sir, I've done my piece de resistance, sir.
Oh.
My own play, what I written myself, sir. Yeah. Oh, it was a big success, my own play.
It was a success.
Oh, didn't you hear the critics on Sunday afternoon?
No, I can't say I did.
12:10 every Sunday, they're on. Well, they went. They were so excited about it, sir. The Spanish one, sir, Ricardo Oranges. The second my play was mentioned, he went straight into the Castilian. Knockers, senior rotor, he said. And as soon as the leading lady was mentioned, he couldn't contain himself, sir. Buzzami mucho, he said. Oh, you see, it was well received.
Well, now, tell me, Mr. Scuttle, what was your play about?
Well, sir, it's about an introverted extrovert, sir, who has an Oedipus complex, sir.
Oedipus?
He hates cats. So one day he goes round and calls on a friend of his who is a taxidermist, you see. And this taxidermist is just finishing off a Siamese cat. Now, this fella, Herbert his name was, sir, he comes in and he sees this Siamese cat. He goes berserk, sir. He picks up a bar, advances towards it. The taxidermist says, "What are you going to do with that Siamese cat, mate?" He said, "I'm going to give it a Bangkok." And he does it. Down like that,
well,
it's
not
the stuffing out of it, sir.
What's the denouement?
The what, sir?
The denouement.
Oh, the upshot. This vicious attack on this cat rids himself of his hatred of cats, but conversely, it instills into him the belief that he himself is a cat, you see, sir.
See, does this have an effect on him?
Of course it does, sir. I mean, you know, and the larder's full of fish heads, sir, and that's full of milk. I mean, he never takes a bath. He won't go near water, because like a cat, he's terrified of water. You see, he's like a cat in every way, sir, you see.
But how does he clean himself?
With difficulty. As a matter of fact, sir, it was that scene that got us the Critics' Award, you know.
Really, you mean the newspapers, they like that.
They went mad about it. Peter Black said, and I quote, "If I had not seen it with my own eyes, I would not have believed it." And Clifford Davis referred to it as poetry in motion.
Yes, well, thank you very much, Mr. Scuttle. That was all most uninteresting. Now, I believe we're privileged to be able to see the first of your new science fiction series.
Yeah, I think the lads are threading it up now.
Good. I'm looking forward to this.
Oh, it'll be very good.
People have been prophesying the future since time immemorial. Philosopher Mark Denby prophesied that the world would end in 1906. And for him, it did. Did one of the story you were about to see ever happen? And if so, when? Come with us into the realm of the supernatural and take that all-important one step behind...
What on earth's wrong with this set?
Come on, will ya?
Maybe it's some kind of interference. Mrs. Clyburn's been having trouble with hers, too.
She
not stormy outside, is it, love?
Looks clear enough.
Oh, it's time we were in bed anyway, love.
Good night, my son. Don't be too late coming up. That's a good lad.
But don't forget, Timmy. Don't be too late.
Timmy, love.